Morning, good. Good morning, everyone. Good morning. I want to take this opportunity to welcome you to our service at Bethel Church. It's the fourth Sunday. Whether you're watching online or you're in another arena, we hope that you are tuning in to us. From Pastor Ruth Van Smith and members, we want you to know that you are highly valued and you are not alone. We are a church that really cares. I want to say a special good morning to our youth and young ones, wherever you are. We pray that you are tuning in. God's blessing will be upon you. While we have gone through some trying and difficult times as a country, and yes, even the world, we can rest assured that God is still has the whole world in his hands, and it's going to be all right. Life has been a bit challenging for many over the nearly 2 years as we have continued to navigate the global pandemic, as well as many other challenges, too numerous to mention. We have heard a lot lately about the 15th letter of the Greek alphabet, which, does anybody know the 15th letter of the Greek alphabet? Omicron. Can you imagine? And what is the name of the virus that's now affecting us? Okay. While we know it's a real situation, be the first and the last letter of the Greek alphabet has to be read in Revelation 22:13. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, first and the last. We know that God is in full control. Although this may not be the format for which we typically worshiped 2 years ago, it is a gift to have technology and allow us to worship together, even if we're not physically in the same place. Because God has said to where two or three are gathered in his name, he is in the midst. So even in this international pandemic that we are going through, we will continue to gather and worship him. And we will sing together and pray together. We are so glad to have you have chosen to worship with us today. It is my prayer that someone will be blessed and take Jesus as your personal savior throughout this worship service. Welcome, everyone. At this time, we will have our opening song, Hear Our Cry, O Lord.
Hear my cry, O Lord. the land of rain. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Till we are wet until we soak in His mercy, in His glory. Thank you, Jesus. Now we will have our doxology. Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. From the bottom of our hearts, that we have come to praise the Lord. Our call to worship. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Your feet have been standing within your gates, O Jerusalem.
For the king of the Lord is better than a thousand elsewhere. I would rather be a doorkeeper in the house of my God than to dwell in the tents of wickedness.
For the sake of the house of the Lord our God, I will seek thy good. O Lord, I love the habitation of your house and the place where your glory dwells.
For the Lord is in his holy temple, that all the earth keep silence before him.
Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer.
Sing unto the Lord a new song, for he has done marvelous things. I will sing of justice to the Lord. I will sing.
Amen, amen. Our hymn of praise this morning, 568, God of our Father. Very steadfast song of the church. strength. No matter what we're going through, we know we have someone that we can call on, and he will be there and lift us. Keep that in our hearts and our minds. Trust. That's the biggest thing we have to do, is trust and believe. Even though we cannot see it, we don't know how it's going to work out, but we know it's going to work out. It's going to be all right. At this time, we're going to have our intercessory prayer by Sister Karen Tucker. If anyone that wishes to have prayer, that wishes to come and join her at the altar, feel free to do so, because God hears your prayers no matter where you are. But feel free to join her at the altar.
Hallelujah, 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 thine the glory. O magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together.
Yes, Jesus.
Your word says, enter into thy gates with thanksgiving and into thy courts with praise. God, and we come this morning offering you a crescendo of praise and thanksgiving. Lord, we thank you. Not because of the type of week that we've had and that because of what you've brought us through. We thank you not because of what you've done for us or given to us or provided for us, but we come offering a thanksgiving just because of who you are. You are high, you are lifted up. You are almighty. You are an awesome God. And so, God, if we had 1,000 tongues, we couldn't thank you and praise you enough, God. And so, Lord, we just say thank you from the bottom of our hearts, from the depths of our souls, oh God. Father, as we've come into your house one more time, God, to worship you, to praise you, Lord, to be filled up with your word. God, your word says we're two or three are gathered, and there are more than two or three here today. So God, we know that you're already here. We know that you're amongst us, kind Father. So Lord, as we sit and we praise and we worship and we pray and we experience you, God, we pray, God, that it will be one that you will be pleased with, God, that our praises and worship will be like a sweet smelling savor unto you, O God. We pray, God, that our souls will be edified, O God, that we'll be filled up, God, so that when we leave this place, we can leave prepared and fed and nourished to go out and work and serve in your vineyard, God. Father God, as we come, Lord God, we thank you, God, for all of those who are here, kind Father. We thank you for your presence. We thank you for the musicians, God, who come giving of their time and to sacrifice to worship you with music, God. We thank you, oh God, for our prayer leader this morning, our worship leader this morning, dear God, Sister Vicky, dear God. We pray that you will touch her, that you will use her mightily, dear God. And that even as she leads us in worship, dear God, that you will minister to her, kind Father, in her place of need. We thank you, oh God, for the speaker, kind Father, and we pray, God, that as the words go forward, kind Father, that you would anoint her lips of clay. God, that you would hide her behind the cross, kind Father. Lord, we pray, God, that she will, that you remove any anxiety that she may have, kind Father. Let her know that her strength is from you, kind Father. And who you call, you equip. So she's equipped this morning because she has you with her, kind Father. So I pray that as the words go forward, kind Father, they will go forward with power, dunamis power, God, that it will pierce our hearts and our souls, God. So we say thank you, God, for what's going to come. Lord God, we just come right now. As we were listening to the song in on the screen at the start of the service, Lord God, you bid us to come, all those who are weary and all those who are burdened and all those who are heavy laden, God. And you tell us to come to find rest in you, God, because only you can give the rest to our souls that we long for, kind Father. Lord God, only you can give us the rest, kind Father, that we don't need to worry, kind Father. Lord, it's only in you. You tell us to take your yoke upon us, God. When we hook up with you, God, you take all of our burdens, oh God. When we hook up with you, God, You make it light, God. You are a burden bearer, kind Father. So, God, I pray for every concern, every worry, every care that is around this altar today, God. I pray that they will cast it. That's what you tell us, to cast our burdens on you, God. So whether it's our children, whether it's our husbands, whether it's our parents, whether it's some relative or coworker, whatever the situation, whether it's our finances, whether it's our health, God, we know we can bring it to you, God. We know, God, that you hear our prayers. We know that you are a prayer answering God. We know, God, that you do all things well. And so, God, if it's a healing that somebody needs this morning, dear God, I pray that they will stretch their faith towards you, just as the woman with the issue of blood. She stretched her faith towards you, God. She stretched her hand through the crowds, God, and all she needed to do was touch the hem of your garment, God. And healing virtue left your body and healed her, God. So I pray that whoever needs a healing today, God, will stretch their hand of faith to you, God, even if their faith is only as small as a mustard seed, God. And Lord God, that your healing will come down from the crown of the head to the soles of the feet, my Father. Lord God, if it's somebody who is in need of finances, God, I pray, oh God, that your provision, dear God, just as you did for the children of Israel, God, you provided fresh manna every day, God. Just as you did for the Shunammite woman, dear God, you kept refilling her jars with oil, oh God. So God, let us put our trust in you, not in our strength, not in our resources, but in you and you alone, God. God, I pray, God, for every situation, every concern. If it's somebody who is worried, dear God, their husband is not being right, their children are not acting right, God, I pray, God, that they will give it to you, God, because you tell us, God, to be anxious for nothing, not to be concerned, but to give it to you by all things, by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, Lord. So, Lord, let them put a thanksgiving on their prayer before they even utter their need, God, because you already know what they are in need of, God. So let them have enough faith this morning to thank you for the answer in advance, oh God. Oh, Lord God, meet each and every need. We say thank you, God. Lord, we bring before you our island home. God, there's so much going on in our island home. But God, whether it's political, whether it's Omicron, whether it's the violence, God, none of it is bigger and greater than you. And so, God, we just continue to seek your face. We pray, God, that you would extend your hand down in our community, oh God. But Lord God, we know that you have no hands, no feet on this earth now, except be it for us, kind Father. So all of us that call ourselves your children, dear God, let us be moved, God. Let us be moved to be active in our communities, to preach the gospel, to share the word. Let someone know who you are, God. Let us go out and to serve you in the way that you would have us to, kind Father, because the need is great, kind Father. Lord God, we pray for our shepherd this morning, the shepherd of this flock, kind Father. I pray, God, that you will continue to do a new thing in her, Lord God. In 2022, dear God, I pray that she will see you and hear you and experience you like she hasn't before, God. I pray that every care and concern that she may have, God, that she will lay it at your feet, God. I pray, God, that you will show yourself mighty to her in 2022. Lord God, and we know that she carries much on her plate, but God, remind her, God, that it's not greater than you, kind Finder. Remind her, God, that the enemy will come to distract her, God. Let her keep her eyes stayed on you. Your word says you'll look to the hills from whence cometh the help. So she'll continue to keep her eyes on the hill, continue to keep her eyes on you, God. Strengthen her, undergird her, do a new thing in her this day, God. We say thank you, Lord. And so, God, we now turn this furtherance of this service over to you. Have your way, Holy Spirit. We say thank you. And so when we leave this place, God, that you will be glorified, your people will be edified, and we will go out singing your praises and will serve you. We thank you, O God, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
I can search for eternity, Lord, and find there is none like you. Oh, there is none.
Under our wings, under our arms, in our path, no matter what we are going through, no matter what, he is always there by our side. At this time, we will have our scriptures by Sister Sherry with her.
Good morning, church. Praise the Lord. Today's scripture is taken from Psalm 27, verse 11. Say amen when you found it. I'll be reading from the NIV version. Teach me your way, O Lord. Lead me in the straight path because of my oppressors. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his holy word.
Hallelujah.
Good morning, everyone. As we've come to worship and magnify the Lord today, we give birthday greetings for this week. Happy belated birthday to Brother Scarlett, who's celebrating his birthday on the 20th. On the 19th, amen, amen. On the 27th, Sister Jasmine Keynes and Sister Karen Tucker. And on the 29th, Sister Janice Wright. So to these members, we say happy birthday to you. It's our prayer that God will continue to bless and keep you, and may you have many, many more. Our Founders Day, it will be held this afternoon at 4 o'clock on Zoom only. The details have been posted to the Bethel chat, and I believe also sent out by email. So you're invited to join us this afternoon at 4 p.m. as we celebrate our Founders Day. The conference lay organization will be having their lay annual meeting on Saturday, January the 29th, also on Zoom, and those details will be sent to the membership at the appropriate time, at a later date. Amen. It's offering time. As we come this morning, we come as obedient children unto the word of God, that we bring our tithe unto the storehouse of faith, knowing that indeed God will supply all our needs according to his riches in glory. So as our ushers come this morning, they will raise our morning offering. Our gracious and our sovereign God. Indeed, God, we can declare and shout that, God, you've been good to us. So, God, this morning we come to bring our tithes and our offerings, dear God. God, we come to give our best gifts unto you this morning, not only in finance, but also, God, in worship. So, God, receive all that we have to give today. In the name of Jesus the Christ, amen.
Thank you.
We have a very special presentation this morning from a gentleman, Mr. Kellen Bassett, who is the Development Manager of Age Concern. And we have been doing our utmost to have this gentleman present to us, and this is the time. So at this time, I would like to have Mr. Kellen come forward and we can welcome him.
Good morning, everyone. As she said, my name is Kellen Bassett. I'm the Business Development Manager at Age Concern. Firstly, I'd like to say thank you for having me here, Pastor Ruth. Yes. And thank you, congregation, for taking the time to come out and hear this presentation. So, is it okay? Here we go. So, as many of you know, Age Concern is a local nonprofit which focuses on increasing the quality of life of Bermuda's 50-plus population. Now, we do this in a couple of different ways, three ways specifically. First is our client services. That's where we offer the majority of our nonprofit work, where we fund the more vulnerable older citizens of Bermuda. As you can see here, our mission is, I don't know if you can read that, but it says is to enhance the quality of life and to promote the rights and opportunities of older adults in Bermuda. And our vision is to have Bermuda as an international community of excellence where optimal health and well-being, financial dignity, civil participation are equitably experienced by people as they age. Go to the next slide, please. Right, so these are the three different services we have. First, like I said, is our client services. That's where we offer the majority of our nonprofit work. So if you give a donation to Age Concern, client services is where it will go to. And basically, we help out with our hardship program. If people are food insecure or need prescriptions or rent or phone or electricity bills, they call our client services line and we'll be able to help them. Next is our advocacy. So that's where we act on behalf of the 50 plus population across all levels in society, whether it be to lobby government for something that the older adults need, or whether it's to speak on behalf of someone to a corporation or to a company that we feel they were changed that needs to be done. And thirdly is our membership department. And that's what I'm actually responsible for. So our membership, and that's what I'm here to talk about today. And this membership program offers discounts on products and services across the island. We offer an education series, which covers a lot of the main topics that people will face as they grow older. And we have activities and events as well. Now, of course, the activities and events have been put on the back burner for now, just to, due to COVID safety. But as soon as we're able to, we will get that calendar back up and running. Go to the next slide, please. So this is just a short snippet of my team. That's me in the middle there with the light shirt. And then, yeah, we have a small team, but we have a dedicated team. So can we go to the next slide, please? Okay, so like I said, our membership department offers three different things. Merchant discounts, education series, activities and events. Go to the next. All right, so first up is our merchant discounts. That's where members save up to $500 to $700 per year on discounts on goods and services. Yeah, so again, I'll send the church this slideshow so you guys can read it in case you can't read on the slide there. But basically, we have discounts in food, in fuel and auto repair, on clothing and footwear, on health and fitness, on medical supplies, on legal services, beauty supplies, and home and landscaping. And you see there was a brief breakdown on the different companies, or some of the different companies that offer. And as you can see here, this is the average amount that people save per year in each of these different areas. And when you add them all up between all these different areas, you get to around $600 to $700 per year that people are saving for nothing at all, right? Get to the next one. Okay, so next is our education series. Now, at Age Concern, we feel that it's never too late to learn a new skill, especially when you get to the later parts of your life, you have to focus on different things, financial planning, retirement planning, legal things like power of attorney or wills and estates. So what we do is we gather professionals from across the island and who donate their time and energy to make sure that our membership is aware of all of their different rights and responsibilities in all of these different areas. And again, we do this once per year, between around March and August. That's when our education series is scheduled. Now, may I ask what happens if you miss a session, right? Well, luckily, because these sessions must be held over Zoom for obvious reasons, but one good side of that is that we can record them. So we have all of these different sessions recorded in our database at Age Concern. And unfortunately, it's too big to go on our websites. The files are too big. But if you email us or give us a call, and you are a member, of course, then we can send it directly to you. So you always have access to this information. All right. And then lastly, we said is our activity and events calendar. So go across, please. All right. So this is a few examples of the different things we offer in our activities and events calendar. So we have an arts and crafts group. We have Scrabble tournaments, chess tournaments, there's morning yoga, there's fitness classes and nature walks because of our move to our new location at Admiralty House. So we moved there around 5 months ago, or about a little under a year ago, actually. And once the pandemic starts to ease up a bit, we will hold things all around the park there, and it'll be free for members, of course. So yeah, this is just a brief snippet breakdown of what you get for membership, and you might be asking, how much does this cost, right? Saving $600, $700 a year on discounts, get a free education series, you get activities. Well, it turns out it's not that expensive. So our bronze, we have different levels of membership depending on your age, but all levels get the same things. So the difference is just in age. Our bronze members, their age is 50 to 64. That's $35 per year. Our silver members are aged 65 to 79. That's $28 per year. And then if you're 80 and above, you're considered a gold member, and it's actually free of charge. So at that point, we just want to make sure you get access to the resources that we have available. So if you guys have any family or aunties or uncles who are at that stage, let them know. Go get your discounts, go get your membership card, it's free of charge. And if you are above 50, it'll still be worth it for you, of course. All right, so how do you become a member? One is you can email info@ageconcern.bm. Just put your name, number, we will contact you and walk you through the membership process. You can also give us a call directly at 238-7525. Between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. Monday through Friday. All right, so that's a short presentation. Thank you for inviting me. Thank you, Pastor. And if anyone has any questions, please feel free to ask. Okay, guess I was pretty thorough. Thank you. All right, well, again, thank you, Pastor, and thank you, congregation, for having me. And if you ever want to get in touch with Age Concern, again, it's info@ageconcern.bm or 238-7525. And I'll be sure to email this presentation to your I'll send it to Pastor. So in case you guys want to refresh, just contact them. All right, thank you very much. Sincerely, thank you guys.
I just want to thank you very much for that presentation. Mm-hmm. Even though I am a member of Age Concern, there were several things that I did not know. Very happy and glad that you were able to present that to us. And I invite everyone to take advantage. Don't let nobody know your age. As long as you're over 50, you're in.
Yeah.
Okay? So you're good. Thank you ever so much.
I appreciate it. Thank you. If you guys want to have me back at another time, I'd be happy to.
So. Thank you ever so much. Much appreciated.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay. At this time, we are going to have a selection by the praise team. And just before they come, Excuse me. As you know, we have our evangelist, Dorothy Young, this one who's going to be bringing us the word. And God has blessed her and he has put a word on her heart. But we know her, but for those that are not know her very well, I'd just like to give a brief bio about evangelist Dorothy Young. She gave her heart to the Lord at the age of 10 at an after-school Bible club at North Shore Gospel Chapel. She says that God had given her heart to the young people, and she spent 1 year at Camp Hope as a camper at the age of 15. And the next year, she went back as a counselor in training and worked her way into a full-fledged counselor. She was assigned to the counselor as a teen, to the teen girls. This marked her commitment as a counselor for Hope Ministries for over 30 years. Dorothy has been a Sunday school teacher for 18 years, is a Christian education director at Richard Allen AME Church. She spent time as a volunteer, as a reading mentor for YouthNet, and she also assisted with the after-school Bible club at Elliott Primary School, which during her time there, 9 students and 1 supervisor accepted the Lord as their savior. Although Proverbs 4:23 is her favorite scripture verse, she uses Proverbs 11:30 as her mantra for working in God's vineyard. The fruit of the righteous is the tree of life, and he that wins souls is wise. Amen. This keeps her passionate in her labors of love and has fueled her to receiving the souls and winner's crown for her master. Finally, Evangelist Dorothy is a mother to Reese Christian Young, her hunk of burning love. Oh, wow. And now towers over her at 5'7". She says of him that he is and has been a pleasure to raise. The next voice that you will hear after the praise here would be that of Evangelist Dorothy Young.
Everybody join in. Oh, Sister Carmen. You're seeing it as well with myself. Thank you.
Soul. I hate to sort of compare the singing of this hymn to like eating my favorite food, like barbecue chicken. That was so delicious. Jesus. It is well with my soul. Come on, let's Hallelujah. Sing that one more time. It is well.
It is well.
It is well. Lift up your voices. It is well. It is well. My goodness. I want to start at the end of the sermon and ask, where will you spend eternity? Because it is well with my soul today. It is well. Is it well with your soul? My God, I pray that will be your portion indeed. Good morning, Bethel. It is an honor, a privilege. I'm excited and nervous all at the same time, but it is great to be here representing the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. His name is Jesus, by the way. Amen. Let us open in prayer. I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice, and it told its love to me. But I long to rise in the arms of hope and be closer drawn to thee. Great God in heaven, would you draw us in right now? Would you cause our hearts to melt in your presence? Would you saturate this sanctuary with your presence? God, we are here to spend time with you. Open our hearts and our minds. God, we've been so busy from Monday to Saturday, but it's your time now. I pray that you would saturate the recesses of our minds with all thoughts of you. Help us to reel it in, to hear what the Spirit has to say. O Holy Spirit, great leader and guider into all truth, would you help us to know the truth of who you are today? We pray for every heart and every listening ear, that as your word goes forth, it will meet them at the place of their need. You're worthy, God. Help the listeners to know that they too have worth and value. We bless you for this opportunity. We absolutely don't take it for granted, God. Bless this lump of clay and let me willingly be used as you see fit now. Thank you for this opportunity. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Isn't God good? Isn't God good? Even if you feel like you can't admit that, let me help you. God is good. I want to talk a little bit about today. Do you know where you're going to? My topic this morning stems from an article written in the New York Times. The article is written about a young man who, while seeking enlightenment, disappeared into a hiker's Bermuda Triangle. Justin Alexander Schouter is the subject of Harley Rustad's new book, Lost in the Valley of Death, a story of obsession and danger in the Himalayas. Justin's adventurous journey led him through many tumultuous paths and experiences. Having shed most of his earthly possessions and lived many lives, amassing a substantial number of social media followers, he hyped each new adventure with beautiful visuals and deftly packaged videos of his life on the road. As Rustad leads Schouter from the rebuilding of a school in earthquake-decimated Nepal, to pyres of the dead in Varanasi, to Parvati Valley, he tells us there's a little problem at hand. Since the early 1900s, dozens of international backpackers have vanished without a trace while traveling in and around the Parvati Valley, an average of one every year, earning this tiny, remote sliver of the subcontinent a dark reputation as India's backpacker Bermuda Triangle. I don't have to tell you that the world we live in is becoming increasingly unstable. With the pandemic, politics, poverty, recession, and racial tensions, emotions are high and morale is low. It can be a struggle to walk in light during these times. Do you know where you're going to? Diana Ross's theme to Mahogany says, do you know where you're going to? Do you like the things that life is showing you? Where are you going to? Do you know? Do you get what you're hoping for? When you look behind you, there's no open doors. What are you hoping for? Do you know? I want to appeal to the young people this morning. I know that there are young at heart people here also and listening in. I'm not going to leave you out, but my real focus is our young people. How about the 50 pluses below? How about that? Took that off of age concern. Amen. Lend me your ears, but for a few moments. You see, some of you are truly seeking, some of you have stopped seeking, and some haven't yet begun seeking. I want to provide you with a little encouragement this morning. You need direction in this world today. You're growing and changing. You will find that you need to adjust in varying ways as you mature. You will need some wise counsel, and I have found that the Word of God is one of the best places, if not the best place, to draw that wise counsel from. So come, join me for a few minutes and hear how you can engage God for some definitive direction. Amen. While Psalm 27 and 11 sheds a bit of insight to seeking God for the trajectory one is to take, whether planning or seeking his direction, it reads, teach me
Thy way, O Lord, ways, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. First, let's look and unpack the first portion of this verse. Teach me thy way, O Lord. Ways, I said it again, ways. The psalmist is asking God, give me to understand the meaning of thy providences, providences meaning destinies or wisdom. In other words, David is asking God to help him to know his way, God's way of doing things. Have you ever heard the saying, give a man a fish, you feed him for a day, but if you teach a man to fish, you feed him for a lifetime? You see, the idea is this. It is more worthwhile to teach someone to do something for themselves than to do it for them on an ongoing basis. Someone taught you how to tie your shoelaces, how to brush your teeth, how to coordinate your outfit, etc. And so it is with God. He will teach us from his word, his way of doing things, such as praying, memorizing his word so that you may hide it in your hearts and use it as ammunition against the devices of the enemy. Also, studying to show yourselves approved unto God, a workman that need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. So in Proverbs 22:6, parents are encouraged to train up a child in the way they should go, and when they are old, they will not depart from it. Parents are aids to godly counsel. Listen, young people, Proverbs 6:20-23 reads, my son, obey your father's commands and do not neglect your mother's instruction. Keep their words always in your heart, tie them around your neck. When you walk, their counsel will lead you. When you sleep, they will protect you. When you wake up, they will advise you, for their command is a lamp and their instruction a light. Their corrective discipline is the way to life. The word of God to me is like yummy, yummy, yummy. Like, who knew? Like, God is like so exciting. It's not boring reading his word. And I think sometimes we have trouble with that because we think the King James Version is a little thou and thy. But there are so many other translations today that help to bring it down to the way I'm speaking to you now that we can get it. And so it makes it exciting. But I reference this passage because I want young people to understand that as parents, being aids to godly counsel, I believe that God, through your parents, is constantly and consistently teaching you, just as now God is teaching you through me. Amen? You see, by asking God to teach you his ways, you will find that it is important for you to seek to do what God wants you to do. Let's look at the second part of the verse. David goes on to say, Lord, give me to know my duty in every doubtful case. That's lead me along the right path. He is saying here, Lord, make it plain to me that I may not mistake it, but walk rightly, and that I may not do it with hesitation, but may walk surely. It is not policy, but plainness that will direct us into and keep us in the way of our duty. Proverbs 8:9 says this, as the path of truth is to those that understand and find knowledge, and as the way of holiness is even to such who in other things are fools, but shall not err therein. The verse infers that in some areas of your life, you may lack understanding, but the thing is that when you ask God, you will not go wrong. That is the power and the work of the Holy Spirit. It is he who will lead us into all truth. That is his function. In fact, Psalm 23:3, David says, he restores my soul and he leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. David begs to be guided in a plain path because of his enemies, for his enemies are watching for his halting. They may find occasion against him. People are waiting for us to mess up. Isn't that something? They are. In 1 Samuel 18, verse 9, Saul eyed David, and this quickened him to pray, "Lord, lead me in a plain path, that they may have nothing ill or nothing that looks ill to lay to my charge," even as Jeremiah's familiars did for him, and lay in wait to deceive him and lead him out of the way, as false teachers do, and come upon him at an unawares and take every advantage against him, as Satan does. Be careful, young people. Be careful not to be so quick to take any advice or counsel that is given to you. Seek the Lord. Not everyone is pulling for you. And just as David and Jeremiah had enemies, so do you. Let me further explain this way. Have you ever traveled overseas? I'm going to go to the young at heart with this bit. Rented a vehicle. You set the GPS in motion. The global positioning system. Is that what it is? GPS? Well, it sets the direction for you to reach your desired destiny. Am I right? Sure. Well, how many of you use your spiritual GPS? The God positioning system. The posture is prayer. Unlike the vehicular GPS, the spiritual GPS has unending guidance and direction to any destination you desire. However, it must be aligned with the Spirit's system. And sometimes the vehicular system has the automated voice that will sometimes say something like, recalculating. And this is due to either road works or changes in the routes that have occurred for upgrades. But the God positioning system does not allow for recalculating, nor does it require upgrades, because his instructions are sure and God's word never fails. It is us who will have to recalculate or recalibrate ourselves to meet the system's, that is, the Spirit's requirement. You with me? One thing that both systems do have in common, though, is this. If you decide to ignore the given instructions, then you may choose your own path and outcome to which they are not responsible. Got it? Mm-hmm. We know, young people, that there are many paths out in our world today. But please understand that we make an infinite number of decisions in our life. Some are clear-cut, but others, not so much. What do? When we don't know what to do, then there's no apparent right answer and no obvious wrong. Then we just want what God wants, but have no idea what that is. Well, we should consult God. Some of you will be graduating from various levels of education. Some may be possibly heading to college or even to the professional environment. Let me advise and encourage you to ask God for direction. Lord, what am I to do here? Where am I to go? Who am I to see, Lord? Please show me, Lord. James 1:5 says, if any man lacks wisdom, let him ask of God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given. We must remind ourselves of the truth that God doesn't want his will to be a mystery to us. Come and draw near to him in faith, asking him to guide you. Now, he won't write the answer in the sky or tattoo it on your forehead, although sometimes I wish he would do just that for me, because that would be so easy. It would be so easy. But when the time is right, he'll open doors and maybe he'll close a few first. He'll bring conversations, information, and opportunities your way. He'll nudge impressions on your heart that he confirms in other ways. Some of you are longing to be a part of the in crowd. You want to fit in. You are charting and checking how many followers you have and how many people are following you and a particular artist or actress. You want to know how many likes you have. You want to belong. You want to make sense of what's happening with your body. But my goodness, if we seek, if we but just seek and ask the Lord for direction, He can help us. Many of you are acquiring good education and doing the best to honor your parents. Seeking to find your place in this world can be a very challenging experience. Indeed, you are faced, just as adults are, with temptations of every kind on every hand. It's funny how on social media, I just spoke about wanting to fit in and be a part of the in crowd, and how the media has everyone looking like flawless models, leaving you feeling pressured to measure up. You don't have to measure up. You're created to be different on purpose, by design, so that you can stand out, understand and know that there's only one you. I'm glad there's only one me. I can only contend with one me in this world. Be grateful that there is only one. There's nobody like you. No, can you imagine? There's nobody like you. So be yourself. I'm gonna end with this. Young people, I want you to take some time to read Proverbs 1:20-23. You see, the psalmist asks of God to lead him in a plain path because of his enemies. And I know he was talking about physical enemies. But we have some enemies that want to steal things from us. We have some enemies that are like jealousy, you know? Some enemies like bitterness, you know? We have some enemies that we really need to seek God's counsel about, because those things we can't handle on our own. We can't. You want to be liked? Somebody may not like you. You can't make people like you. You know, you want to fit in? I was always on the outs. You know, I always wanted to fit in, but I never fit in. I couldn't understand why. But now I understand why. You know, I began to seek God. But my seeking was only because I wanted to know why I don't fit in. I wanted to fit in so bad. But God showed me that, I made you this way by design. You're never going to fit in because I set it up that way, as it is with a lot of young people and 50 plus people. You're not going to fit in no matter how hard you try. Stop trying to fit in and just be who God wants you to be, who He's designed you to be. And if you don't know, you've got to seek Him more so you can find out. He is the one who created you. He is the one who can tell you what your purpose and destiny is. Stop asking other people. They don't know. So you will find that following God can land you in the right place. His GPS never leads you astray. So Proverbs 1:20-23 reads like this, but I'm only going to read a snippet of the passage. I'm going to read 28-23, and I want you to read 20-23 because it's going to lend this passage in its proper context, which is very important. So the heading of this particular portion is Wisdom Shouts in the Streets. Now, if somebody is shouting at you, they need you to hear them. If somebody is shouting your name or saying, "Don't do that," they're trying to get your attention, right? All right, listen to this. Verse 28, when they cry for help, I will not answer. Though they anxiously search for me, they will not find me. For they have hated knowledge and choose not to fear the Lord. They rejected my advice and paid no attention when I corrected them. Therefore, they must eat the bitter fruit of living their own way, choking on their own schemes. For simpletons turn away from me to death. Fools are destroyed by their own complacency, but all who listen to me will live in peace, untroubled by fear or harm. Please read that passage. Proverbs chapter 1, verse 20 to 23. Just like your parents give you advice or wise counsel, and you still choose to do your own thing, this passage is letting you know how God feels about that, and the advice and the counsel he gives you, and you still choose to do your own thing, and what will happen to you in choosing to do your own thing. So when you seek him in prayer, prepare your heart to do the things his way that he is telling you to do, even if you do not understand it, Dorothy. Just as Justin Schultz, I had heard about India's backpacker Bermuda Triangle and the statistics on how people had vanished in that area, he still made the choice to venture there to explore. No, he didn't disappear, but he was aware of the possible consequences of visiting the site. And anyway, don't take a risk and end up in your own Bermuda Triangle of sorts. Choose to take the risk with God. After all, a risk with God is a risk worth taking, isn't it? That's pretty good. Yeah, I thought that was pretty good too, Holy Spirit. I really want to pray for our young people today, wherever they are. They're struggling. And sometimes they want to be heard. They really have a voice. And sometimes the 50 pluses dismiss them. We really do. They come with new ideas, thoughts, they're creative, and sometimes we really shut them down. And then when they end up in certain places, locations, and things happen to them, we wonder why. Maybe because they just wanted to sing one little verse of Jesus Loves Me and you wouldn't let them, but they wanted to do it in a rap style or something. I don't know. All I'm saying is they have a voice. Let's give ear to that voice so that we can engage them and help them. Yeah, it's okay, because the babies are now telling you how to use those iPads, right? Listen to them. They're so, listen, I don't know if I ever shared this before, but I'm gonna share this. They're so smart. So some time ago, during one of Bermuda's festivals, there was a storyteller who came, and he was saying, children, babies, they're brilliant, they're smart. You know, they come right from the mind of God, they're brilliant. He said that as they grow older, they get stupider and stupider. You know why he said that? Because all of this stuff around, it taints what God put inside. So I'm glad that God left us a Bible. I'm glad, because that's where you're gonna have to go. That's where the children have to go back to get centered, to get focused. Back to Proverbs 22 and 6, train up a child in the way he should go. When he is old, he will not depart from it. So I don't mean to say they get stupider and stupider, but the thing is, you know, this is temporary. This is not our home, right? Just passing through. But that's what we have to teach them. And we have to engage our young people more. And they come with this idea, and it sounds like off the wall. It's off the wall to you. But if you just give it a chance and see how it works, then you'll be like, I am so glad I considered that. Listen to them. They want to be heard. More than anything, my spirit tells me, they want to be heard. And there's a radical generation coming up that if you don't want to take the time to listen to them, trust me, they're going to be heard anyway. This generation is a generation that has the smarts. They're bold, they're courageous, and if we can just kind of teach them how to soften, polish up their vocabulary a little bit, oh yeah, they are not hindered about what they want to say. So the storyteller who came years ago and made that claim that as they get older, they get stupider and stupider, this group right here, oh, they're on the money. So tap into that, pray for that, and help to channel that. Don't discount them, because they're here. Just as you are, God sent us here with purpose, for purpose, on purpose. So it's a real thing. All right, so let's just offer a prayer for our young people. They are thebomb.com. You all just don't know it yet. Yeah. You got to give them their due. You got to give them their due. They are thebomb.com. So kind Father, we lift up our young people wherever they are. Wherever they are, they are seeking, they're longing, they are displaced. Some of them feel like they don't belong, like nobody loves them. Save for your love, God, would you teach us how to love them? Would you teach us how to embrace them? Would you teach us how to teach them that you love them, that we love them? Teach them that they are an awesome people, that they are to make manifest your glory, and to teach them that their shrinking doesn't serve the world. God, we know that you've gifted our young people with talents and gifts beyond measure. But God, some of them will never know that if we don't sit down and talk with them and find out how they're doing, what they aspire to be, where they want to go. Some of them really don't know where they're going. They need you and they need us to help them. So would you lift them up today? Help them to know that they are loved. There is a community of people, and not just church people. There's a community of people who love them earnestly and honestly and want to help them to grow and mature. There's one wayward by the side. There's another one in the club. There's another one in the streets. They're breaking in homes. They're murdering one another. God, our young people need you. They need direction. They seek direction. And we may not have all of the answers. But, oh God, there is one in heaven. There is one who has his spirit amongst us that knows the answer. And his name is God. God, pull them in. Pull in our young people. Help us to, yes, we get tired, but God, as you are long-suffering, teach us how to be long-suffering, to go after them, to go after them. We can never tire. If we want to say, see change, we got to be change. Help us to love our young people, to embrace our young people, to give them a chance, because they will find it somewhere else. The streets love our young people. The bars love our young people. Help us to know that. It's a serious charge. So keep our young people today, oh God, in your care. And young people, we love you. And help us to show them their worth, their value, and how to keep themselves. Yes. We thank you for our young people. In Jesus' name, in Jesus' name. We pray. Do you know where you're going to? I want for 2 seconds to turn our hearts, our attention to our hearts. This is inclusive of everyone. I started out saying, do you know where you will spend eternity? Have you saving knowledge of Jesus the Christ? Perhaps some of you are seeking for direction today. I can assure you that as Jeremiah said of God, if you seek me with all your heart, you will find me. God wants to know you. He wants you to know him. He desires a relationship with you. If you desire to know him today, take a few minutes. Maybe you're tired of running. Maybe you've sought so many outside resources. A lot of the times when we're seeking resolve to situations, we seek outside of ourselves. And I don't know who taught us to do that, but the answer is already inside of us. There isn't one person that God has sent to this earth that doesn't have everything they already need. It's already inside of you. Everything you need is already inside of you. So I'm here to tell you today, from now on, when you're seeking resolve, you seek within, the God within you. will give you the answer you need. And if that answer is not plain because he didn't drop it out of the sky, then he's going to impress upon your heart something like this. Somebody's name might keep coming to you. That's the person you need to contact to help you. Okay, that's what it looks like. Like, God is a spirit. So you've got to learn to discern him by the spirit. That's the only way. Spirit unto spirit. That's the only way you're going to get to know what God is telling you. Okay? He works through the hearts of other people. But until you seek him, you won't know what direction to go into. All right? And that's real important. It took me a while to get that. You know, you want to go and look at a book, or somebody's on a program you want to watch. Seek God first. And then if you're feeling, why do I want to watch XYZ all of a sudden? I never want to watch that program. That's it. More often than not, that's the key. All right? The Spirit's going to lead you that way. So I've given those people who have wanted time to think about whether or not they want to make a commitment to this great Jesus that we serve, giving you time. If you've made a decision, come pray this prayer. Pray this simple prayer with me, would you? Come on. Lord Jesus, I admit that I am a sinner. I know that I've not obeyed your commands. I know that I've not loved you. But I believe today, I believe in my heart that you came and you died for me on a cross. You shed your blood for me that I might be saved. I confess I am indeed a sinner. But would you save me today? Would you adopt me into your family and help me to build a relationship with you? In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. For those of you who are joining us via Zoom or Facebook, if you made that confession of faith, you can contact Bethel at 293-0605. Someone absolutely and unequivocally will assist you in your need. They will help you to know this God. Okay? Finally, I just pray that as we go throughout serving God, that we will truly, truly ask God. It's one of my favorite passages, Psalm 27. But ask God to teach me thy ways, O Lord, and lead me in a plain path because of mine enemies. Okay? May the God of peace be with you all. It is my prayer. Amen and amen.
There's a part that used to say, the road is rough.
The road is rough, and the going is tough, and the hills are hard to climb. I started out a long time ago.
There is no doubt. Praise God for his word this morning. a word not just for the young people, but a reminder to all of us that we must know where we're going and to whom we belong. So Evangelist Dorothy, thank you, thank you, thank you for coming this morning and sharing a word of God for all of God's children, young in age, young at heart, that we must know that Jesus is the way.
Yes.
Amen. Let us now stand for our doxology as Evangelist Young will give our benediction. And if I can ask Sister Karen Tuck, if I can meet you quickly after church, I've got some documents for you to sign.
Restores my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. May his peace be with you till we meet again.
Our corporate worship has ended, but our personal worship must continue. Have a great week with the great God. Our closing hymn is I've Got My Mind Made Up.
Got my mind made up, and I won't turn back. I want to see my Jesus someday. I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back. But I want to see my Jesus someday. I've got my mind made up, and I won't turn back. But I want to see my Jesus of my life.